said you were leaving for Boston tonight. Rita told me.
I was going to call you.
I didn't realize you'd be leaving so soon.
Well, I didn't see any point in putting it off. Arranged for me to start classes, and the sooner I get started, the sooner I catch up.
Well, that sounds like a sensible thing to do. Where will you live, do you know yet?
Well, they found a place for me. I can move right in.
But will you be able to manage on your own? I mean, it's going to be quite a job getting all your things out of here.
Well, Rita and Norman are going to come over and help me pack, and they're going to drive up with me.
Well, that's good. Then you'll have company. I'm glad I dropped by.
Yes, I was going to call you. I wanted to talk to you. I think there's some things we have to sell.
Yes, I did want to talk to you about the house.
What about it?
I thought you might want me to put it up for sale.
Don't you want to move back here? You don't have to do this for me.
Well, I don't want it to be over between us.
I don't either.
But it is, isn't it?
No.
No meaning yes.
Betty, I don't want our marriage to end any more than you do.
Then let me come with you.
I can't. Not right away.
But why not?
Because I want to start classes. I want to start studying. I want to have a whole new routine for myself, and I have to do it on my own. I want to do it on my own.
I mean, how long am I supposed to wait here before you send for me?
Come here. I want to show you something. It's over the river, and it's big and roomy. Probably need to go to Peyton. It was musty, but hey, and it sure isn't this place.
But I love it already.
I want you to move, Betty.
Well, when? I mean, a week, 2 weeks, a month? What?
Listen, I gotta sit down. Okay.
But this time it's really going to work.
I think we have a chance. But we gotta get one thing settled between us. I'm your husband. And I'll take care of you.
Well, what you're saying is that if I do come to you, I have to forget about your grandfather's money, forget about the will and everything.
And everything. Betty, I want the same thing you do. But nothing comes for free. Not even an inheritance.
But I mean, if we give it up without a fight, I mean, suppose something goes wrong. Suppose we really do need that money.
You mean if I don't make it back all the way, if I can't get rid of those braces? Don't worry about that. Well, that's something for you to think about. Either you believe in me or you don't.
But then what you're saying is that it's up to me.
It has to be. We can't mess up this time. I know we love each other, but sometimes it's not enough. If we can't be happy together, we've got to face that fact right now before... Or something.
I love you more than anything.
Betty.
I don't care about the money. I don't care where we live or how we live. I just want to be with you.
Betty, the kids are going to be here in a few minutes. Hey, how long do you think it's going to take you to pack a toothbrush, Mrs. Harrington?